A while back, I reviewed 5 Stop Motion apps, and Stop Motion Studio was the best. So in this video, I'll give you a full tutorial on how to use it.
Lights.
Camera. And Lego.
So first, just download it from the App Store. It should be free unless you're buying the Pro version. It'll download fairly quickly. After it is downloaded, just open it up. You should come to a screen that looks a little bit like this. For this tutorial, I'll be using an iPad, but you can use a phone as well. The iPad will just look a little bit different, but that's alright. They still have the same features. Now that you have downloaded Stop Motion Studio, it is important to set up your camera, set, and lights. Here's some clips of me setting everything up. Go into Stop Motion Studio again. You will see a stop motion there by default. You can watch it if you want. Now create a new project. And then you should come to a screen that looks like this. Before you take any photos, you might just want to go through the settings by clicking the gear icon down below. You can first select the speed of your stop motion. The highest is 30 frames per second and the lowest is 1 frame per second. I suggest starting in the middle with 15 frames per second, but if you are a beginner, just start with 10 frames a second. The next setting is to the right. This is if you want your frames to fade. By default, it'll have no fade. Leave it like this. Moving to the right, you have your aspect ratio. Again, leave that the same. Then you can change your foreground. And again, just leave that the same. The next setting is filters. Many you must pay to use, so just leave it. You can also change the quality. Leave this on HD, meaning high definition. Finally, the last setting is playback. There should be nothing selected, and leave it like this. Then click done. There are so many settings and features that you can tweak, but I'll just explain to you what they do. Across the top bar, you will see an arrow. This is to allow you to go back to the home screen. Next, you can see a mic icon. This will allow you to voice record right onto your stop motion. To the right, you can see a plus button. This can do a variety of different things. You can add images, add title screens, add audio, and more. Unfortunately, you must pay to put in sound effects from Stop Motion Studio, but you don't need to pay if you are just voice recording. Moving on, you'll see the gear icon, which we already went through. Then there are two arrows. By pressing the one pointing left, it'll scroll to the start, and the one on the right will go to the end. At the end of the bar, there's an undo arrow. This will undo your frame. A really helpful feature while making stop motions is this tool to your left of your screen. It's called onion skinning. Slide the dot into the middle of the line. This tool allows you to see your previous frame without going all the way back to the actual frame. To the right of your screen is an icon that has 3 lines. By clicking this, it comes up with a whole bunch of new settings. So I'm just going to tell you what they all do. It is up to you how you want to change them. So the first setting is about the actual camera. You can flip it to the front camera or use the back one. And if you pay, you can have an effect of green screen. The next setting is the mode. You can select whatever you want. You can have it in auto, manual, and other modes that are all in between. When selecting it, it tells you some information on what the mode does. I suggest using manual so you have more control over your frames. When you select manual, it'll come up with more settings to play with. So if that's selected, the next setting to the right is white balance. You can make the color a bit warm or blue depending on which one you choose. Moving to the right is focus. You must choose a number that won't make your subject blurry. I would use 10 to focus on things that are far away, and 6 for subjects that are close. Next is ISO. Making the number higher, the camera becomes more sensitive to the light, making the image brighter. And if you want to lower the number, the camera will become less sensitive, and the image will become darker. The next setting is shutter speed. Scrolling to the left will make your image darker, and scrolling to the right will make your image brighter. Change this to suit the look you are going for. The next setting is zooming. There are two ways to zoom. The first way is to just scroll on this setting, and another way is to simply pinch on your image and gradually make your fingers widen, like you would normally do when you're taking a normal photo. But just take note, when you zoom on common iPads and phones, the lens of the camera doesn't actually zoom. It is just zooming on the pixels. It's just like cropping. When you zoom on these devices, it'll bring down the resolution, making the quality bad, but it's fine to zoom just a little to get unnecessary things out of your shot. And finally, the last setting is rotation. You can select one of these options if you want. Your image can look normal, flipped horizontally, flipped vertically, and rotated 180 degrees. Now click done and all those settings are saved and just the way you want. Also, when you take your first frame, it comes up with a whole bunch of new settings. All are basically self-explanatory. I'll just show you a video of me going through the edit button. And now, to take photos. Normally there's a red button on the side, but there's a little trick to take photos without pressing the button. If you have these kinds of earbuds, then connect it to your device. Then press the volume button and it'll take a photo. You don't even have to press anything on the iPad. This makes your stop motion smoother because you won't bump the iPad. This is a really great tool, but you can also use the timer at the top right hand of the screen. So here's the stop motion I took, completely using Stop Motion Studio. And there you have it, that is Stop Motion Studio explained. I was so surprised how many tools this app has. You can take photos and edit all on the same app. It's crazy! If you don't already use this for your stop motions, I really suggest you use it. Also, in the App Store, Stop Motion Studio Pro is $9, but on Amazon it is $5, so by clicking the link in the description to get to Amazon, you can save $4 on your purchase. With getting Stop Motion Studio Pro, you can unlock features of adding audio, unlocking green screen, unlocking many filters, and more. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye!
Like!
And subscribe
or watch another video.